Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is decimal fractions. Okay, in previous chapter we have learned about the vulgar fraction, in which we have seen that the many operations on the fraction. Okay, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division we have done. Also we have learned many types of the fractions and other concepts. Okay, so we have seen vulgar fractions in which there were denominators other than zero, except zero all were the denominators. Okay, so what in the decimal fraction, what is mean by decimal fraction? Decimal fraction, you know, fraction means part of whole, so this is also part of whole, decimal fraction. But why it is given separate particular name decimal fraction, that we are going to learn. And we are going to learn all the other concepts like we have learned in the vulgar fraction. Okay, so see, there are such fractions whose denominators are 10 or 100 or 1000, okay, or 10,000. That means there are such fractions whose denominators are multiples of 10, that is 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, and so on. 10, 100, 1000, likewise means all these 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 1 lakh, 10 lakh, 1 crore, like this. So these are the multiples of 10. These are the multiples of 10, means these denominators. So the fractions having these denominators are called decimal fraction, okay. So now see here, so how to write and how to understand the decimal fraction? There is separate writing system for the decimal fraction, that also we are going to learn. Now you know that, just remember here, the fractions having the denominators 10, 100, 1000, that is multiples of 10, are called decimal fractions. Okay, now see here, this is one of the number, that is 4975. Okay, in this, from right side, the rightmost place is called ones place. Ones place or units place, okay? Units place. Second last place is called tens place, okay? Third last, hundreds place. And this place is called thousands, okay? In this way, we write these places of these numbers are written. Ones, that is units, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore, 10 crore. Means as it goes on the left side, this is units place, right? This is called ones place, that means one, okay? Multiply by one. This is called tens place, that means multiply with the 10. This is called hundreds place, that is multiply by 100. And this is called thousand place, that is multiplied by 1000. Understood? Means if you want the value of this 5, 5 is at ones place, so its value is 5 into 1, that is 5. 5. Now 7 is at 10 states, its value is 7 into 10, that is 70. 9 is at 100 states, its value is 9 into 100, that is 900. And 4 is at 1000 place, its value is 4 into 1000, that is 4000. Understood? Okay. So if you see this, now instead of this number, I will take another number. With the same digit. 9999. Now what will happen? See. 9 into 1. 9 ones means 9, 9 tens means 90, 9 hundreds means 900, and 9 which is at 1000 place means 9 into 1000, that is 9000. Okay, now see the pattern. 9999. If you see the pattern, the value on the digit on the right side, so left side, the digits on the left side are greater by 10 times than on the left side. Means what? If you see the difference between this 9 and this 9, value of this 9 is 9. Value of this 9 is 90. That means 9 in this 9, then we will multiply with the 10 in this 9, we will get 90. 9 tens are 90. Get it? 9 tens are 90. That means the 9, the digit on right left side, the digit on left side is 10 times more than the digit on the right side. Similarly, if you see the value of this 9 and this 9, then the digit on left side is again 10 times more. See, the value of this 9 is 90, value of this 9 is 900. So, 90 when you multiply with the 10, 90 tens are 900. Getting? 90 tens are 900. Similarly, 900 tens are 9000. Okay? 900 tens are 9000. Means what? Value of the digit on left side increases by 10 times than the value of digit on the right side. Understood? Means on left side, the value goes on increasing. On the left side, value goes on increasing. Value increased by 10 times. 10 times means multiply by 10. By 10 times, value goes on increasing. Okay? Opposite of this, if we talk about value on the right side, see here, the 9 is in the thousands place, its value is 9000, okay? If you want to compare this with the 900 on right side, if you want to compare the value on the of the digit on the right side, then it decreases. Decreases means become less. By how much times? You know, 9000 and 900. So 900 is less by how much times than the 9000? It is less by 1 by 10. Getting? Means what? If you divide 9000 by 10, 9000 divided by 10. Simply cut this 0, what will get? 900 ones are 900, correct? So, as value goes on increasing towards left side by 10 times, opposite of that, value goes on decreasing on right side by 1 by 10 times. Okay? 1 by 10 times. Means what? See, this is 9000, this 900 is 1 by 10 of 9000, okay? Again, 90 is 1 by 10 of this 900, and 9 is 1 by 10 of 90, okay? So, value goes on decreasing on the right side. Understood? Now, suppose if we want to extend this on the right side, this is the rightmost place is ones or units, okay? If we want to extend, increase this again on the right side, what will happen? If you want to extend this again on the right side, then what will happen? You know, when we goes towards the right side, the value decrease by 1 by 10, okay? Value decrease by 1 by 10. Decrease means become small. Okay, so when we go towards right side, value goes on decreasing by 1 by 10, whereas when we go towards left side, value goes on increasing by 1 by 10. Okay, so if you want to extend this towards the right side, then what will happen? See now, here the last place is 1's place, then if you want to go towards right side, again I write here 9. Then what is place value, or what is name of this place, Now see, we have to go to the, towards the right side, okay? So, the value, what will be its value? The 1 upon 10 of the previous one. So, 9 into 1 by 10. That is 9 1 is 9. 9 by 10. Okay? Again, this is 9 by 10. 9 10th. Again, value of this 9. 9, this 9 into 9 by 100. Understood? Why? Because this is 9 upon 10. So here 9 upon 10 into 1 by 10. Value of this 9 is 1 by 10 of previous one. 9 upon 10. That will be 9 ones are 9. 100. 10 tens are 100. Okay. And value of this 9 will be 1 by 10 of 9 upon 100. That will be 9 ones are 9 and 100 tens are 1000. That is 9 upon 1000. Okay. See how value is going on decreasing. You know, as we go on the right side, the value will go decreasing by 1 by 10. Okay. So now value of this is 9. Value of this 9 pulse is 9. On the right side, value of this 9 will be 1 by 10 of this 9. That is 9 upon 10. Okay. Value of this 9 will be 1 by 10 of previous 9 upon 10. That is 9 1 is 9, 10 10 is 100. 900. And value of next 9 will be 1 by 10 of previous one, 9 upon 100. That is 9 1 is 9, 10 10 is 100, 1000. 100 10 is 1000, okay? That is 9 upon 1000, that is 9000. So see this place. Now I will write directly these values here. 9 upon 10. 9 upon 1000, 100, 9 upon 1000. Okay, this 9 is 9, this 9 tens means 90, this 9 hundreds means 900, 9000 means 9000, okay. So now, as we move towards the right side, here 9 divided by 10, 9 divided by 100, 9 divided by 1000, if one more 9, if you write here, there will be 9 divided by 10,000. Okay? Now see, what is the name of this place? Only 9 means 9 ones, 90 means 9 tens, 900 means hundreds, and 9000, thousands place. 9 upon 10, what is place, the name of this place? 9 upon 10, it is called 10th place. What? 9 upon 10 means it is 9 10th. Okay? So this place is generally called 10th. T-E-N-T-H, 10. Because there is upon 10, divided by 10. 9 upon 100, that is 900th. So this place is called 100th place. 100. And this place is called 1000th place. There can be any digit. Instead of 9, there can be any digit. Okay? So this is 9 upon 1000, that is 9000. If there is 4, then it can be 4000th. 1000th th, okay? 900th th, 910th. What is difference between this side and this side? See, this is 1's place, 10's, 100's, 1000's. Okay, and here 10th, 100th, 1000. Understood? So, in this way, if you want to extend our number system towards right side, it will increase in this way. It will go on increasing in this way. Divide by 10, divide by 100, divide by 1000, divide by 10,000, divide by 1 lakh, 10 lakh, etc. Okay? So, this is given in the textbook, refer that. So now, see here, as I said you once, this is once, tens, hundreds, thousands, and on this side there is tenth, hundred, thousands, okay. So all the time we cannot write number in this way. All the time we cannot write number in this way. 4 upon 10, 6 upon 100, 7 upon 1000. All the time we cannot write number in this way. Okay? Generally, if we write this whole numbers, suppose the number is 5375. Okay? So its place values are different. All the time you cannot write this way 5000, then 300, then 70, then 5. All the time you do not write in this way. Okay? So what to do? So see, the number is on this side, right side, there are digits, suppose 4, 3, 2. Okay? So this can be written as 4 upon, this can be written as 4 upon 10, 3 upon 100. 2 upon 1000. So all the time we will not write in this way. Then how to understand whether there are decimal or whether the 4 is 10th place, 4 is at 10th place, 3 is at 100th place, 2 is at 1000th place. How to understand? For that we have to put decimal point where the whole number gets end. Here it get whole number gets end, okay. So here we will put decimal point. This is called decimal point. Now on the left side of the decimal point, whichever number is there, it is called, as we have seen in fraction. And the number on the right side, it will be decimal number or fractional number. Means it is not whole, it is not complete one, it is part of one, okay? Fractional number, fractional part, okay? 5375, suppose I have 5375.432 rupees, that means I have complete 5375, complete rupees, and again I have 432 paise, we can say. It's not complete rupees, okay? Understood? So this, the number after decimal, it is called fractional part, and the number before decimal, it is called whole part, okay? Whole number. So this 432, the number on the right side of the fractional number, how to read this? This can be read as short number one, 75 point this. This is decimal number, okay? The number on the right side is called whole number, and the number on left side is called whole number, and the number on the right side is called fractional number or decimal number, okay? Now whole number can be read as it is, as we read usually 75. And while reading the fractional number or decimal number, what we have to do? We don't have to write this way. 75.25, no, 75 point, don't forget to say this point, say or write this, don't forget, 75 point, now what, how to write this, 25, no, we have to write it in this way, this 2 and this 5, so 75.25, okay, if the number name is given 75.25 and we have to write numeral, we will write this way 75.25, and if number is given, numeral is given, and we have to write number name, then in this way 75.25. or another example, So here whole part is this 630. So 630 point, what we write this 037 037. Okay, in this way we'll write, we will write. So here if you see 75.25 means this is ones place, this is tens place, and this is which place? The first place after decimal point, it is called tenth place, and second place is called hundredth place. Okay, that means 5 ones means 5, 7 tens means 70, 2 tenth means 2 upon 10, and 500 means 5 upon 100. In this way, we can write its place value. These are called place values. Okay. If you want to write this, you can pause this video and write in your notebook. After this, we are going to solve the exercise which is based on this. And while solving exercise, again, I revise this concept. So it will be fixed in your mind. So open your textbook, page number or Xerox, exercise 10. Okay, exercise 10, which is based on the decimal fractions or decimal numbers. Now see, first convert the vulgar fractions in question number 1 to question number 10 into decimal form. See here, they have given vulgar fraction whose denominator is not 10 or 100 or 1000. Okay, so these are the our vulgar fractions: 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 3 by 4, 1 by 8, 7 by 40. So these fractions can be converted into decimal fractions. These fractions can be converted into decimal fractions. How to convert? How to convert? It's very easy. You know, 1 upon 2. What is meaning of this? 1 divided by 2. What is meaning of this? 1 divided by 2. So let us divide 1 by 2. Let us divide 1 by 2. Pay attention. 1 divided by 2, that means 1 divided by 2. 1 divided by 2. Now see, we have to divide 1 by 2. But 1 is smaller than 2. Okay, then by which number we will divide it? We will divide by 0. 2 zeros are 0. Or we will say in the table of 2 till 0. 2 zeros are 0. Now 1 minus 0, 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. Okay. Now the remainder is 1. Now remember, we have to convert this into decimal. So we have to keep on dividing the given number till we get remainder 0. Now, but we cannot divide directly. Now you will say, yes, there is remainder 0. Remainder 1. So again we will say 2 zeros are 0. No. Once we have done that, now to divide this remainder, we have to take license. License. What is that license means? How can we get the license of dividing 1 by 2? After putting decimal point. Okay? After putting decimal point. How to put decimal point? Here in the question. Okay, see, there was only one digit, that is 1, we divided 1 by 2, so 2 zeros are 0, now remainder is 1. Now again we have to divide this remainder. So to divide this remainder, when we can divide this remainder now? When we put decimal point in the quotient. Decimal point in the quotient, okay. So now we have put decimal point in the quotient. So what is the benefit of this? We get 1 0. We get 1 0 that we can put after remainder. When we put decimal point in the quotient, we get 1 0 that can be put after remainder. Now so now remainder has become 10. Remainder has become 10. Okay. Now let's divide 10 by 2. Is that 10 in table of 2? Yes. 2 5s are 10. Now 10 minus 10? 0. Understood? So now what is the answer? 0.5. So 1 by 2 is same as 0.5. This was our vulgar fraction. When we converted it to decimal fraction, we got 0.5. Okay? Next. Pay attention carefully. We have to solve many examples so you will understand this concept. 1 upon 4. This is our vulgar fraction, usual fraction. We have to convert it into decimal fractions. 1 upon 4, other meaning of 1 upon 4 is 1 divided by 4. Let's divide 1 by 4. Since 1 is smaller than 4, we will say table of 4 is 0. 4 zeros are 0. Okay? 1 minus 0 is 1. Now denominator, remainder is 1. Remainder is 1. We have to divide it till we get remainder 0. So how can we divide? By taking decimal point in the quotient. Take decimal point or write decimal point in the quotient. So when we take decimal point in the quotient, we get 1 0 that can be put after remainder. Okay. Now remainder. Now we have 10. So let's divide 10 by 4. 4 2's are 8. Okay. Now 10 minus 8 is 2. 10 minus 8 is 2. Again, remainder is 2. And what we have to do? We have to keep on dividing till we get remainder 0. Now remainder is 2. But don't worry, we have taken decimal point. When as we have taken decimal point, we have got license of putting 0 after remainder. Okay. So listen carefully. Only we have taken only one decimal point, that is enough. Or you will say, for this decimal point we have taken for this 0. Again to take 0 here, we need to keep one decimal point here. No, we have taken only one decimal point, so using that we are allowed to take 0 after every remainder. Okay. So now there was remainder 2, we put 0 after 2. Let's divide 20 by 4. 4 5s are 20. Got remainder. Here now remainder got 0. Finish. So 1 by 4 is same as 0.25. Okay. Next. 3 upon 4. That is 3 divided by 4. Again 3 is smaller than 4. So we have to say table of 4 is 0. 4 zeros are 0. Remainder is 3. We have to divide this 3 by 4. So when we can divide? When we will take decimal point here. Okay. So put decimal point in the quotient and take 1 0 after 3. Okay, we are allowed to take now 0 after remainder. 3 became 30, divide 30 by 4. Now 30 is not there in table of 4, 4 7s are 28. Okay, so 0 minus 8, not possible. 10 minus 8 is 2, 2 minus 2, 0. Again, remainder is 2, but we have decimal points, so we can give 0 after 2. Okay, that is it became 20. Now 4, 5 is 20. Finish. So 3 by 4 is same as 0.75. Okay. 1 by 8, that is 1 divided by 8. रिमेंबर डिनोमिनेटर टेक एज अ डिवाइजर एंड न्यूमरेटर टेक एज अ डिविडेंड इन द ओके सो वी हैव टू डिवाइड दिस न्यूमरेटर बाय डिनोमिनेटर दैट इज 1 डिवाइड बाय 8 नाउ 1 इज स्मॉलर देन 8 सो 0 0 0 8 0 0 0 1 रिमेंबर इज 1 टेक डेसिमल पॉइंट पुट 1 0 ना 8 10 डिवाइड बाय 8 ओके सो 8 वन्स आर 8 10 माइनस 8 2 अगेन देयर इज 2 वी हैव टू डिवाइड दिस 2 बाय 8 सो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल सो पुट 0 आफ्टर इट वी हैव डेसिमल पॉइंट वी हैव टेकन वन डेसिमल पॉइंट दैट मींस वी आर अलाउड टू टेक 0 आफ्टर रिमाइंडर नाउ 8 2s आर 8 2s आर 16 20 minus 16, directly put. 20 minus 16, 4. Okay? Again, remainder is 4. Okay, we have to divide 4 by 8. So, directly we cannot divide. We have to take 0 here. 4 is not divisible by it, so we have to take 0. We have decimal point, we can take 0 in any number of times. Okay? So, see here, 40 divided by 8. 8 5s are. Finish, we got remainder 0. Understood? So, 1 by 8 is same as 0.125. Next, 7 upon 40, that is 7 divided by 40. 7 divided by 40. Now see, 7 divided by 40. 7 is not there in table of 40, so obviously we divide by 0. 40 zeros are 0. 7 minus 0 is 7. Now put decimal point here, take 1 0. It becomes 70. Now 70 divided by 40. You know 40 table? 42 are 80. 120. That is table of 4 and 1 0. Okay? Now there is 70. So 40 ones are 40. Because 42 is 80, 70 is smaller than 80. See, there is now 30. There is now 30. Okay. Again, 30 is not divisible by 40. So, as we have decimal point, take one more 0 after it, it became 300. Remember, when we take decimal point, we can put 0 only after remainder, not any other digit except 0, only 0. Okay. So now there is 300. 300 divided by 40. 447 is 280. 47 is 280. 48 is 320. So there is 300. So we have to take smaller numbers. So 47 is 280. 0 minus 0? 0. 0 minus 8? Not possible. 10 minus 8? 20. And here 0. Now there is 20 divided by 40. Okay, 20 is smaller. So put 1 0 became 200. 40, 4 5s are 20. Similarly, 4 40 5s are 200. Okay, 0 minus 0, 0, 0. Finish. So 7 upon 40 is same as 0.175. Okay. 7 upon 40 is same as 0.175. So in this way we can convert polygon fractions into decimal fractions, decimal numbers. Understood? Pause this video, write these examples. We will see many examples also. Okay. See now next question. Example number 6. 9 upon 50. We have to convert these vulgar fractions into decimal fractions, okay? So how to convert? As we have seen, 9 divided by 15, that means in this way. 9 divided by 15. Now see, 9 is smaller than 50. Then we will say table of 50 till 0. 50 zeros are 0. 9 minus 0, 9. again we have to keep on dividing till we get remainder 0, right? Now see, remainder is 9, okay? So now take your decimal point and take one zero after 9. Now divide 90 by 50. 51s are 50, 52s are 100. 50 means a table of 5 and 2, 1, 0. 51s are 50, 52s are, 2s are 100. But 100 is more than 90, so we will say 50 in 51s are 50. 0 minus 0 is 0, 9 minus 2 is 5 is 4, okay, 40. Again, 40 is the remainder, it is smaller than 50, so put 1, 0. Became 400. Why we are putting 10? Because we have taken decimal point in the question. Okay. Now 400 divided by 50. You know 50 8s are 8 zeros are 0, 8 5s are 40. 50 8s are 400. That is, so 9 upon 50 is same as 0.18. Okay? 9 upon 50 is same as 0.18. Next. 72 upon 160. Don't scare or don't worry. Any fraction we can convert into a decimal fraction. Okay? Any fraction, whichever fraction is given, we can convert into decimal fraction in this way. So now 72 upon 160, that means 72 divided by 160. Now 72, you think that we don't know table of 160, what to do? 160 means 16 table, just write 16 table and put 10. You will get table of 160, okay? The first step is very easy. 72 is smaller than 160, that means we have to say till 0. 160 zeros are 0. 72 minus 0 is 72. Now take your decimal point, put 0 after 72. So we got here 720. Now see here. See, there is no 720 in table of 160, then its smaller number is 640, that is 4s are 164s are 640. How I got this? 16 4s are 64. 16 4s are 64, and this 10 I have put after 64. So 164s are 640. 0, 2 minus 4 not possible, so here 12 and here 6. 12 minus 4 is 8, 0. Again the remainder is 80, put 0, now became 800. Now 800 divided by 160, that is 800. See, 16 5s are 800, 160 5s are 800. 0, 0, 0. Okay, finished. So 72 upon 160 is same as 0.45. Got it? Very easy. Now this 8th one and 9th one, you have to solve by yourself. Okay? I will show you this 10th one. 12 upon 5. 12 upon 5 means 12 divided by 5. 12 divided by 5. Now let's, here 12 is greater than 5. So all the time here we have taken 0 first, because the dividend was smaller than the divisor. But here dividend is greater than the divisor. That means you can divide 12 by 5. You know 5 2s are 10. Now remainder 12 minus 10 is 2. Okay. Now after here remainder is 2. But we have to keep on dividing till we get remainder 0. So what we have to do here, we have to put decimal point after this 2 and then take 0 after remainder. Now remainder became 20, 20 divided by 5, 4s are 20, finish. So
12 upon 5 is same as 2.4.
Understood? So in this way we have to convert vulgar fractions into decimal fractions. Okay, now pause this video. These two examples solve afterwards. We will see next question. Now see, question number, next instruction for the next questions. Convert the decimal fractions in question number 11 to question number 20 into common fractions in reduced form. What is this common fractions? See here. First, let us write the questions. 7.5. 4.24, 18.75, 0.60, 0.625, 0.625, 0.075. Okay, these are the given fractions, and these are the decimal fractions. What is instruction for this question? Convert these decimal fractions into common fractions. Common fractions means our vulgar fractions, that means having numerator and denominator. Okay, these are decimal fractions, we have to convert them into common fractions. See, in the first question, vulgar fractions were there given, that is common fractions were given in the form of numerator and denominator. Here, and those vulgar fractions we convert into decimal fractions. Here decimal fractions are given, and we have to convert these decimal fractions into common fractions, vulgar fractions. Okay. So how to convert? After converting into vulgar fractions or common fractions, again we have to find its reduced form. Reduced form also. Okay. That we know how to find reduced form. Now see how to convert this 7.5 into numerator and denominator. What to do? It's very easy. Just pay attention, it's very easy. Forget this decimal point or put the finger on the decimal point. After putting finger on decimal point, which number you can see? Directly 75, okay? That right here, 75. 75. In the denominator, what we have to do? Write first 1. Write first 1. Then check here after decimal point, how many digit is there? 1 digit. After decimal point there is 1 digit, so after this 1 put 10, finish. 75 upon 10 is the common fraction for 7.5. This is also your correct answer, but again you have to find its reduced form. Reduced form means smallest term. Think that both 75 and 10 are divisible by which number? They are divisible by 5, correct? So let's divide both numerator and denominator by 5. 75 divided by 5, 15. And 5 divided by 10, 2. 15 upon 2 is the reduced form for this 75 upon 10. 75 upon 10 is the common fraction for 7.5. Okay? Two steps we have done. First we converted this decimal fraction into common fraction, and after that the common fraction we converted into reduced form. We know how to convert into reduced form, that we have learned in the previous chapter. Okay, just this step is new for you. Now see 4.24. First you bar, okay, 4.24. What I told you, first put finger on decimal point and see which number you can see. 424, that is 424. Write it as it is without decimal point. 424. Then in the denominator, write 1 first And now see the number. After decimal point, how many digits are there? Two digits are there. So put two zeros. Okay, this is your common fraction. That's 424 upon 100. This is your common fraction for 4.24. Okay. Now move towards the next. That is for find the reduced term or reduced fraction. So what we have to do? 424 and 100. Both are divisible by which number? See here. Here we must know the divisibility test. Okay. Number formed by last two digits is here 24, here 100. 00. They are divisible by 4. See, 24 is divisible by 4 and 00s are also divisible by 4. So 424 divided by 4 and 100 divided by 4. Okay, when we find reduced form, we have to divide both the numerator and denominator by same number. Okay, now let us divide 424 by 4. 4 1s are 4, 2 came down, 4 0s are 0, so 2 minus 0 is 0 or 2, and again 4 came down, 4 6 are 24. That is 106 upon 100 divided by 4, 25, 4 is 100, so 100 divided by 4 is 21. 106 upon 25 is the common fraction for 4.24. So whenever options will be given, question will be given that convert this decimal fraction into common fraction. See the options. If options are given in this way, then need not to find a reduced term. If options are given in this way, then after converting into this the common fraction, again you have to find reduced term. Okay. See the options and then accordingly solve the example. If options are given till this, means in the form of the denominator 100, okay, then need not to convert its find its reduced form. Okay. Next, 18.75. First, you bar, write the number without decimal point, 1875. So that is 1875. And in the denominator, give write 1. Now check that after decimal point, how many digits are there? Two digits are there. So put two zeros. So we will get 1875 divided by 100 or upon 100. Okay. Now reduce form. Here last digit is 5, here last digit is 0, that means they are divisible by 5. Five, 3's are 15, 3 remain, 7 came down, 5, 7's are 35, 2 remain, 5 came down, 5, 5's are 25. Okay, 375 and 100 divided by 5, 25 is 100, so 100 divided by 5 is 20. Again, 375 and 20 are divisible by common number, which is that? They are again divisible by 5. So 375 divided by 5. 5 7 is 35, 2 remain, 5 5 is 25, 75. Okay. Upon 20 divided by 5, 4. 5 4 is 20. So 75 upon 4 is the reduced term for this 1875 upon 100. Understood? Next. 0.60. Now see. 0.60. When you put a finger on decimal point, you will see number 060. Now 060 means 60. So do we need to write this 0? The 0 before any number is its value is 0. So not need not to write. The number is only 60. 0.60 means 60. Now see, write 1 here in the denominator. See after decimal point how many digits are there? There are two digits, so put two zeros. So we have 60 upon 10, 100, okay?
Now to find a reduced term, see both numbers are divisible by last digit 00, that means they are divisible by 10. 60 divided by 10, 6 10, 10 6 are 60 and 10 10s are 100. Correct? Again, they are divisible by 6 and 10 are divisible by again 2, correct? So let's divide it by 2. 2, 3 is 6, 2, 5 is 10. So 3 upon 5, 3 upon 5 is the reduced term of this fraction, 60 upon 100. Next, 0.625. So this can be written as, put your finger on the decimal point, which number can you observe? 0625. And write your 1. After decimal point, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, put 3 zeros. That is 1000. Need to write this 0? Which is before the number? No. Not need to write. 625 upon 1000. This is the common fraction for this decimal fraction. Now 625 upon 1000 convert into reduced term. See, both are divisible by, okay, they are divisible by 5. See, 625 divided by 5. 5 ones are 5. 1 remain, 2 came down, 5 twos are 10. 2 remain, 5 came down, 5 5 is 25, 125 upon 1000 divided by 5. See, 5 2s are 10, then 2 0, 0 is 0, 0 is 0, 125 upon 200. Further, these 125 and 200 are again divisible by then table of 25. If you know the table of 25, then a table of 25. 25 5s are 125, 25 8s are 200. Okay, so 5 upon 8 is the answer. Next, 0.075. Now see, when you put finger here on decimal point, which number can you observe? 0.075. So need to write these two zeros which are before 7. No, not give, because their value is 0 anyhow. You put 1 in the denominator. Now check after decimal point how many digits are there. 1, 2, 3. So put 3 zeros. That is 75 upon 1000. Now 75 upon 1000. Convert into reduced term. 75 upon 1000. They are divisible by 25. How to know that they are divisible by 25? If the number formed by last 2 digit is divisible by 25, then the whole number is divisible by 25. Now see here, 00 means they are obviously they are divisible by 25, and 75 is also the table of 25. Okay, so 25, 3s are 75, and 25, 1000 divided by 25, 25 4 is 0, 25 0 is 0. Okay. 25 4 is 100 and is 0. 3 upon 40 is the common fraction for 0.075. So in this way we can convert decimal fractions into common fractions. Understand both the methods. First one, we converted common fractions into decimal fractions, and then we converted decimal fractions into common fractions. Okay. Today, remaining examples of this question solve and ask me doubts. Now, I am going to send this video. After watching video, ask me doubts. After that, again one video I am going to send today. Okay, so before that, clear all the doubts of this. Tomorrow the test will be conducted. That instruction I will give you. Okay, so now watch this video very carefully and pick out your doubts. If you have any query about this, ask me. Okay. So now, thank you and have a nice day.